Has the Anna Hazare campaign changed Indian politics forever? Joining our panel now is Swami Agnivesh. But before we talk to him, somebody who's played a key mediatory role, in fact, what looked like a moment of intense confrontation between the government and Anna Hazare ended in an extraordinary photo opportunity with Vilasrao Deshmukh, the emissary of the government, sharing a stage with Anna Hazare last night, with them all singing the national anthem together. Earlier today, I spoke with Vilasrao Deshmukh. I started by asking Mr. Deshmukh what the toughest moment was in the negotiation process.
See, I was negotiating directly with Anna. So for me, there was no any difficult thing to do for myself, because I was communicating directly with Anna, and whatever conditions Anna put, that I communicated to Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Finance Minister, and accordingly they prepared a resolution. It was discussed yesterday in the House, and the letter which Prime Minister wrote to Mr. Anna, I delivered to him, and he took a decision to break his fast. So for me, there was no any tough challenge so far as dealing with Anna, because my relations with Anna is quite old. I have dealt him when I was Chief Minister of Maharashtra. He had many agitations over there, but amicably we discussed the issues and we sorted out. So there was no much question for me so far as dealing with Anna, and there is also my personal rapport with him.
Right.
So that has also helped me.
And one of the things that you were tasked to do was, of course, to establish direct contact with him. How did you convince Anna Hazare to accept no voting inside the House when many of his aides were pushing for that?
Barkha, let me tell you, Anna himself was not keen on that, because what has been transpired between me and Anna was a different story. He said that you please discuss these issues in the House. Once you start the discussion, then I will withdraw. But then they insisted for resolution. I think when the resolution was accepted unanimously, so there was no question of having any division unnecessarily. So whole House was unanimous in accepting those issues and sending it to the consideration for standing committee.
That's interesting that you're telling us that Anna Hazare himself was actually not fixated on the idea of a vote. Now, Vilasrao Deshmukhji, you shared a stage with Anna Hazare, but we saw many statements from that stage attacking the political class as a whole. What is your reaction to that?
See, actually, I was not expected to go on the stage. When I met Anna in his side room where he was resting, I showed him the letter. And he decided that he will break his fast tomorrow morning, today at 10 o'clock. But he said that you please come on the stage, read out the letter, and I want to declare in front of you, before the audience, before the supporters, those who came over there. Of course, other Anna team was also there, but I never interacted with Anna team. And you see, when we have some kind of a compromise between the Anna Hazare and the government, so we have to forget all these things. Though they have said so many things against ministers, against member of parliament, but we know we are in politics and we know how to forget and forgive.
You know how to forget and forgive, but do you feel bad that your government didn't have the common sense to involve you before and much earlier as a mediator?
No, there was no question of any mediation on part of me, because you see, when Prime Minister appealed him from the House, the Speaker, the Leader of Opposition, and the whole House was unanimous that Anna should break his fast. So then I took that clue for myself, and I went to Anna to inquire for his help, because many people from his own village, from Maharashtra, they were here. Every day they were coming to me, requesting me to please, Anna's health is deteriorating and you must go and convince Anna that he should break his fast. So that was the pressure, especially on me. And so I went on my own. I just sought the permission from FM. I told him that this is the situation. If I go and meet Anna and inquire about health, then he said, go ahead. There is no problem. And then I convinced Anna, this is the high time. You are at a peak. Whole country is with you. Whole parliament is with you. There is no any dispute between the issues. Only thing is the parliamentary procedure and the framework of the constitution. And I'm happy that I could convince him. And there was no any question that has created really any problem between me and Anna.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.